Do sin and iniquity refer to the same thing, and if not, what distinguishes the two? Defining iniquity, the term for iniquity in Hebrew is avon, which translates to bend, twist, or distort. Therefore, iniquities are deviations or distortions of the law or divine teachings to varying extents, all of which merit punishment. Iniquity is essentially a breach of the moral or legal obligations humans are expected to adhere to. It encompasses acts of wickedness and immoral behavior that not only offend society but are particularly abhorrent to God. In Exodus 34 verse 7, where God proclaims his forgiveness of iniquity, transgression, and sin, iniquity is mentioned along with guilt, suggesting it's a state of guilt deserving punishment due to the manipulation of God's laws. David's desire for Bathsheba and his failure to repent led to an escalation of his iniquity because his sin was the act of committing adultery with her. His situation worsened when he arranged for the murder of Bathsheba's husband, Uriah, intensifying the gravity of his actions. David's continuous engagement in greater misdeeds shows iniquity to be a deliberate violation of God's commandments, driven by personal desires that take control of a person's life. As seen in David's case, do sin and iniquity refer to the same thing, and if not, what distinguishes the two? The term for iniquity in Hebrew is avon, which translates to bend, twist, or distort. Therefore, iniquities are deviations or distortions of the law or divine teachings to varying extents, all of which merit punishment. While sin and iniquity have their differences, both necessitate redemption through the sacrificial blood of Christ. This redemption was made possible as described in Romans 5:9, through the justification provided by his blood, shielding us from divine wrath.